eyes nines. Above average for a lady.
Burglar used a pry bar. Why did you kick the door in?
You think I'm gonna climb through a broken window in a $30 suit? You got another thing coming, Buster.
Celine and Jacob are obviously having problems. It speaks to motive.
Crime scene evidence still weighs against it being the husband. Jacob could be. Am I after drank like this, would you feel on the back of my hand?
Call in burglary and get technical services out here. I'll talk to the neighbors.
Don't take all day about itself. I'll get nasty when I'm thirsty.
Tiffany? The rest of the stuff is junk. Might explain the missing ring. Regular Amelia Earhart.
Number 564.
The ring looks distinct.
Technical services for a suspected 459 at 142 North Union.
LAPD, are you acquainted with Celine Henry, Mrs.?
Horgan! Jennifer Horgan. I've known Celine for more than 10 years. Our children grew up together. What's going on, officer?
Did you see Mrs. Henry go out last night?
Well, I'm no busybody, you understand, but Celine had been drinking. And she and poor, long-suffering Jacob had a terrible row. I think Jacob may have given her a black eye. He stormed out and she went back inside.
Did he come back?
No. Celine was listening to music and shouting until she left around 10 p.m. She was very drunk to have been driving. But she is not the sort of person you can stop from doing something when her dander is up. What is this about, officer? Is Celine all right?
I'm afraid Mrs. Henry has been murdered, ma'am.
Murdered? Oh, my God. I'm afraid I need to go and sit down.
Let's see what Jacob has to say for himself.
I don't think Jacob is our man, but we should see what he has to say.
That's that cop.
You can drive.
Seems like a decent guy.
It's in the Jacob's history.
Okay, Phelps, we go in hard. You follow my lead. You Jacob Henry?
Yeah. Who's asking?
LAPD. You're under arrest for the murder of your wife, Celine Henry.
Murder? Celine?
Save the dramatics for RKO, pal. You got bigger problems.
What the hell are you talking about? You come in here, you tell me that Celine is...
Take a seat, Mr. Henry.
She's...
We're gonna have a look around, then we'll talk.
Jesus, I'm sorry.
I get even the slightest hint that you're a flight risk, pal.
You think the atmosphere's thick in here? Wait till you try the gas chamber.
The oldest problem there is, what to do about the old lady.
Back
Kaiser Levens.
So who could have killed Celine? Where did she go last night, Jacob?
A bar, I suppose. Look, I don't know.
You know where she went, Jacob. You're lying. Why would I help you if you keep lying to me?
Look, I'm telling you, I don't know.
We know she went to the Bomba Club.
The bartender there, he calls me if things are getting out of hand, and I go and I bring her home. He called me last night. I said no. Phone rang a couple more times after that. I ignored it. I'm gonna have to live with that.
When did you last see your wife, Mr. Henry?
Last night. I went to see her. We talked. Things got a little out of hand. I left.
You don't remember what time you last saw your wife alive?
Look, I'm sorry. I left. Maybe 9 p.m. Might have been a little later, but right around 9.
Why did you kill her, Jacob? Things will go better if you come clean about it.
That's a lousy thing to say. I never gave up on my wife.
I don't believe you, Jacob. I think you didn't have the guts to do it yourself, so you had someone else do it.
You want to back that up with something, Big Mouth? Huh?
The note by the phone suggests you meant her harm.
You want the truth? Truth is, I was sick to death of her. I was trying to have her committed.
We're still going to need you to come downtown, Mr. Henry.
We can get this all down on paper, Jacob. How you got fed up with your wife and how you figured killing her would bury all your troubles.
Kill my own wife?
She was a lush and a tramp, and you just couldn't stand it anymore.
Shut your goddamn mouth.
So now you're going to tell me you loved her? Ah, the DA goes all gooey over remorse, Jacob.
You're awful hot under the collar for an innocent man, Mr. Henry. Doesn't look good for you, Jacob.
Call it in and get a squad car dispatched. And check for messages. I'll keep old Slugger here company.
Operator, give me dispatch.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
I need a patrol unit to transport a suspect back to Central.
Certainly, Detective. You have a message from the coroner. Do you wish to be put through?
Yes, ma'am.
Carruthers.
It's Phelps.
I've completed the autopsy. Several wounds to the head from a blunt metal instrument. Closest match would be a socket wrench handle.
So the cause of death was the blunt?
No, the blows to the head surprisingly were not fatal. Death was from hemorrhage and shock from the fractured ribs and multiple injuries caused by the stomping.
Anything else?
He's some kind of sex fiend. The tissues of the anus were bruised about 1/8 of an inch, but no trace of semen in the anus, vagina, or stomach.
Thanks, Doc. Operator, give me R&I. Any word on an owner for that vehicle? License was 2BOY8899?
Yes, Detective. The plate belongs to a brown 1936 Pontiac. Registered owner is one Alonzo Mendez of 402 South Fremont Street, apartment 16.
Thanks. Any other messages?
One, Detective. From Captain Donnelly. He wants any and all suspects returned to Central. Interviews to be set up immediately.
Got it. We're coming in. You know the way. You can drive. Carruthers said she took a real pound. We have a firm lead, Captain.
Are you questioning my judgment, Cole Phelps?
No, sir.
Good. I thought not. Jacob Henry is a subsystem pushed around by his wife. I think with the right kind of persuasion, he might be prepared to seek absolution. Are you prepared to show him the error of his ways, young Phelps?
I don't think he's our man. Galloway agrees with me.
Don't drag me into this.
Rusty is a practical policeman. A bird in hand is always worth two in the bush. Let's liberate a confession from poor Jacob and the public will sleep easier tonight. Run along now, Phelps. I've warmed him up nicely for you.
Doesn't look good, Jacob. You're in a big jam here. You lie to me and I can't help you out. Do you understand me?
Yes.